management of HIV infection? What are the goals of antiretroviral therapy, the ART, the antiretroviral therapy? What are the goals of treatment of HIV infection? Is to, first of all, reduce the viral load. Second, increase the CD4 count, so as to combat the infection. When you reduce the viral load, the risk of, you will reduce the rate of transmission, very important. So one of the most of goals of the ART is to reduce the transmission to the others. On the same time, we'll improve the quality of life and prevent or treat the opportunistic infections. So these are the goal of HIV therapy. What about the antiretroviral therapy, the classes, the anti-ART, the antiretroviral therapy? We have the nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, the NRTI, and the NNRTI, the non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. These are the major classes of antiretroviral therapy. For example, the nucleoside or the nucleotide, zidovudine, abacavir, or tenofovir, the non-nucleoside, efavirenz, and nevirapine. Okay, these are the non-nucleoside and nucleoside. What about the integrase inhibitors to prevent the integration of the viral genome into the host genome? Raltegravir, this is the new class of medications that prevent the integration of the viral genome to the host genome. There are other classes of antiviral, for example, CCR5 inhibitor, the receptor inhibitor. Maraviroc, this is the new class of agent of drugs. Protease inhibitors, these are all the drugs, protease inhibitors. Ritonavir, saquinavir, and the fusion inhibitor. This is a new drug, fusion inhibitor. Enfurotide, this is the new class of drugs that prevent fusion of the virus to the host genome. So these are the classes of the antiretroviral therapy. The usual regimen for the antiretroviral is a combination. So we have to act through different modes of the life cycle of the virus to increase its efficacy and decrease the chance of resistance. The standard should include non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. This is the standard drug with the combination of other, for example, protease inhibitor, okay, or integrase inhibitor, or we with two non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. So either one, NNRTI with two NRTI, or NNRTI with a protease inhibitor and integrase inhibitor. So you have to do triple drugs. You have at least triple drugs. Monotherapy is not recommended because it increases the risk of early development of resistance. واضح طلاب لحد الآن بالنسبة للـ principles of treatment of HIV.
دكتور سمعت مال the standard combination to retroviral gene.
عفوا ما فهمت السؤال شنو؟
دكتور هي آخر شيء مفتاح مال combination standard يعني ناخذ اثنين.
We have three. We have to start. Three drugs. Either NNRTI with two nucleoside reverse, يعني non-nucleoside with one with two nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. يعني نرجع للسايد قبله يصير واضح. Okay. فاحنا ال principle الأول أول واحد we have to do one non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitor. For example, efavirenz with two nucleoside reverse transcriptase. يعني مثلاً نعطي مريض زيدوفيدين أباكافير with efavirenz. This is one example. أو ممكن ننطي زيدوفيدين with مارافيروك plus ساكوينافير. واضح؟ واضح. It should be three drugs. هذا الرجيم اللي نعتمده. هذا مثلا NNRTI with protease plus integrase or NNRTI with two NRTI. And it should be three drugs. No one drug or dual drug.
تمام دكتور.
ممكن يتعالج الـ HIV لو لازم يعني طول
الفترة اللي هو مصاب. But there is no cure for HIV infection. يعني شلون الهباتيتس بي؟ The aim is to not cure, is to suppress the viral load, improve the CD4 count, improve the quality of life, reduce, not prevent, reduce the HIV transmission. Okay? يعني واحد من patient on HIV treatment, the risk of transmission to that will be low. Of the viral load become undetectable or very low. مو مثل patient اللي was not treated. And will prevent or delay the complications. For example, prevent or develop, delay or prevent the development of tumors. Opportunistic infections, خصوصا إذا CD4 count remain high, يعني for example 400 أو 500, مريض ما راح يصير عنده complication, toxoplasmosis, cryptosporidiosis, وهكذا. Okay, what about the reverse transcriptase inhibitors? We have two drugs prevent will act on this enzyme, the reverse transcriptase enzyme. The non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors, and the nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. These drugs will prevent viral replication. This will prevent viral replication because it will act on the transcriptase enzyme. So it will block the conversion of HIV RNA to HIV DNA. Now, عرفنا أن reverse transcriptase will convert the RNA genome to DNA genome. By doing so, it will prevent the viral replication. And why classes? طبعا عندنا zidovudine, adenosine, stavudine, and lamivudine. طبعا اكو قسم سامعين بيهن مثل lamivudine. It will has also activity against the hepatitis B virus. It has good CNS penetration. Two nucleoside reverse transcriptase in the course of treatment, cornerstone of ART. لازم ناخذ اثنين. واحد to prevent or decrease the chance of resistance. The side effect, including peripheral neuropathy, pancreatitis, hemolytic anemia, neutropenia, cardiomyopathy, and lipodystrophy, especially for stavudine. So these are the nucleoside reverse transcriptase inhibitors. It should be two, not one drug. يعني either zidovudine, lamivudine, or zidovudine, didanosine, وهكذا. عندنا النيوكليوتايد انالوجز النيوكليوتايد انالوجز التينوفوفير ذا برودرج سيميلر تو نيوكليوتايد انالوجز اكسبت ذي ريكوير تو فوسفوريليشنز ات از بري اكتيفيتد سو ذي ار اكتيف دراجز سايد افكت انكلودينج فانكوني لايك سيندروم يعني شو يصير عندهم مريض يعني يصير عندهم رينال تيوبولار اسيدوسيس هايبوكاليميا استينيا نوزيا فوميتنج دياري بس احنا شنو اخذنا النيوكليوسايد والنيوكليوتايد انالوجز what about the protease inhibitors will act on the development block new HIV from becoming mature HIV in the last stage of the development of the virus اللي اخذناها باللايف سايكل interferes with the action of protease and prevent post translational cleavage of the protein. After the translation of the messenger RNA, the protease enzyme will cleave the proteins into the peptides and incorporate it into the viral cell. By doing so, it will interfere with the action of this enzyme and will control the viral replication and reconstruct the immune system. What are the examples? Nalfinavir, saquinavir, ritonavir, and indinavir. Given with a small dose of ritonavir for boosting effects. So ritonavir will boost the effects of other protease inhibitor because it is an enzyme inducer. But unfortunately, these drugs have multiple side effects, especially the GI side effects, hyperglycemia, fat redistribution, lipodystrophy, and may be implicated in coronary artery disease and insulin resistance. So these are the protease inhibitors. fusion inhibitors to prevent, block the HIV entry to CD4 cells in the initial stages of HIV infection. Maraviroc, which is an inhibitor, blocks the CCR5, our receptor. Common side effects, hepatitis. Enfuvirtide, it inhibits the GP41 protein that mediate the fusion of HIV in the infusion. This is the protein, inhibit the fusion, GP41, glycoprotein 41, for fusion to the host cells. Other inhibitors, subcutaneous injections, not oral treatment, and it is reserved for salvage treatment, not the common protocol for treatment of HIV. It's a salvage treatment, because nowadays there are multiple resistance of HIV, drugs to HIV. HIV virus will gain resistance to many drugs. So this is the last resort for HIV infection. Integrase inhibitor will block the insertion of HIV DNA into the CD4, prevent the integration of the viral genome into the DNA host, So to prevent HIV from using the integrase enzyme to integrate or combine into the CD4 T cells instructions. The common drugs, raltegravir or dolutegravir, and these are the new drugs and are superior and safer than protease inhibitors and the non-nucleoside reverse transcriptase. So these are the new drugs for HIV. I have had the answer coming drugs for HIV, integrase, diffusion, transcriptase inhibitors, or protease inhibitors. So that these are the four classes. يعني على الأقل تعرفون كل كلاس وفد ال فد example من كل كلاس. وطبعا الميكانزم اوف اكشن هي مبينه من الاسم يعني اتوقع واضحه يعني الانتجريس البروتيز وهكذا. بالنسبه when we start HIV antiretroviral therapy, when we start all people with confirmed HIV infection, any patient confirmed to have an HIV infection, you have to start the antiretroviral therapy. Before that, all guidelines stated that till the patient reached CD4 count below 200 or the viral load high, we will start the treatment. But now the guidelines, all people who confirm the HIV infection should be treated. So the guideline now, the command starting ART in all people, regardless of the CD4 count or the clinical status. Why? In order to reduce, by doing these criteria, to reduce the morbidity, mortality, reduce the risk of infection to the others. When we suppress the viral load, the risk of transmission to the others will be low. And keep in your mind, it's seldom necessary to start ART urgently, might not be an urgent indication, but we're doing on a daily basis. So no need for emergency treatment. How we monitor the efficacy of the virus? يعني مريض خلينا على HIV treatment, how we can monitoring? First of all, the viral load. These are the points or end point of treatment with the HIV, with antiretroviral therapy. So the viral load, we measure the viral load around 1 month after starting the antiretroviral therapy, the viral load will be decreased and it will become usually suppressed after 6 months of treatment. At the same time, we will monitor the CD4 count every 6 months, and it is usually with the suppression of the viral load, the CD4 count will be increased. And we, during the monitoring of the efficacy, we have to monitor for the side effects. Again, as a class of antiretroviral drug. Keep in your mind that the need for ART is lifelong. And very important to stress the importance of adherence, because if the patient is going to interrupt the drug, there will be a higher chance of development of resistance. And at the same time, depression, anxiety, and substance abuse are common among HIV patients. So I have to counsel them about these important perspectives. What about the principle of post-exposure prophylaxis? This is a common principle in infectious diseases. If the person is exposed to a patient with HIV infection, for example, a needle stick injury. يعني واحد a nurse going during phlebotomy inserted by mistake inserted the needle that is used to aspirate blood from HIV patient injure herself by stick. How we can instruct this person? First of all, clean the site with water and soap and determine the exposure risk. Don't give post-exposure prophylaxis for intact skin exposure. Rather than intact skin, no need for exposure. Post-exposure prophylaxis or urine exposure. Or the source has undetectable viral load, yani zero, undetectable by PCR. Otherwise, you have to do a potent combination of treatment. For example, Truvada plus Raltegravir, and three drugs are Truvada. This is a combination of two drugs plus Raltegravir. And we have to start. You must start within 72 hours. Otherwise, the post-exposure prophylaxis will not be effective because there will be integration of the viral genome into the host genome. So you have to start early, within the first 72 hours. And you should continue for 4 weeks. If the person is initially negative, we have to perform the test 3 months after the exposure to confirm the HIV, because the patient may have in the window period. So the antibodies are negative, PCR is still not detectable because the viral load is still low. So we may repeat the test after 3 months. Water and soap, determine the risk of exposure. Anyone needle stick injury or not, just skin exposed. Then we used to have to start the combination antiviral, antiretroviral therapy within the first 72 hours, and you should continue for 4 weeks. After 3 months, you should repeat the HIV testing. واضح هسه بالنسبة للpost exposure prophylaxis.
دكتور هاي مفتهم انت ما don't give PIP for intact skin exposure or urine.
يعني واحد سكن يعني ما عنده سكن مثلا صار عنده يورن او سلايفا اون ذا سكن اوكي بلود اون ذا سكن مثلا انت ايدك واحد سحبت له بلاد ومجرد دم وقع على ايده يعني انت ما شكيت بالابره اذا ما عندك اذا عندك ووند بالهاند طبعا لازم نسوي بوست اكسبوجر بروفلاكسس بس اذا انت عندك سكن نو نيد فور تو ستارت ذا بوست اكسبوجر بروفلاكسس بس يو جيت انجري ان يور سكن باي ذا نيدل اور اف يو هاف اوريدي ا ووند or a wound on the skin, you have to start the post-exposure prophylaxis. Intact skin, no need for post-exposure prophylaxis. Okay, this is usually applied also for sexual transmission. So if the patient has exposed to during sexual act within the first 72 hours to a patient who confirmed to have an HIV, you have to start within 72 hours. This is very important. After that, there will be no, the drugs will not be effective to prevent the infection. So we will monitor this patient for HIV infection after 3 months. So what about the pregnant lady, pregnant woman? Treat all pregnant women with HIV infection. This is the first principle. The goal is to make the viral load undetectable in order to decrease the chance in utero transmission. Breastfeeding should be avoided. The antiretroviral therapy decreases the risk of transmission from 1% to less than 0.1%. And you get very effective. That has a very negligible risk of transmission. What about the vaccination among HIV patients? The first principle is vaccination with live organism is contraindicated. Number two, immune response to vaccinations are impaired in HIV infected patients because of immune suppression. Therefore, it is preferable to wait until the CD4 count has increased to more than 200 on ART before immunization is given. And حتى إذا ما يضمن على not يعني the recombinant vaccines not with live organisms يعني live vaccine حتى هذا عادة إن immune response will be blunted. So you have to give before antiretroviral therapy. Wait till the CD4 count approach more than 200 cell per cubic millimeter, then we'll start active immunization. واضح طلاب بالنسبة لل vaccinations. So live organisms are contraindicated. The killed vaccines usually have blunted immune response but are not contraindicated, but preferable to wait till the CD4 count more than 200.
دكتور هو الفاكسين مو يمكن ان الشخص يكون اصلا هيلث يعني ما بي له اتش اي في حتى لا يتعرض مستقبلا
يعني ممكن اتش اي في عمره طبعا بس هو الاتش اي في بيشنت از اولسو ا بيرسون سو ات مي بي اليجيبل فور انفلونزا فاكسين فور نيموكوكال فاكسين فور هيباتيتس بي فاكسين يعني عادي حال البيرسون اللي عادي مو صح ولا
دكتور يعني هاي ما الفاكسين اللخ غير اتش اي في فاكسين
ذير از نو اتش اي في فاكسين
ده اقول احنا فهمنا هاش
اي بس فاكسينيشن ان اتش اي في انفكشن فاكسينيشن كل ما ذير از نو اتش اي في صح هو اندر ديفلوبمنت بس طلنا ذير از فيلير اوف ماني فاكسينز اجينست اتش اي في انفكشن بيكوز اوف ذا هيتروجينيتي اوف ذا فايرال بارتيكل ما قدروا لحد الان يصنعون في الافكتيف فاكسين اجينست اتش اي في اند اتش اي اتش اي في فاكسينز يعني مثل نيوموكوكال انفلونزا هيباتيتس بي ديفثيريا تيتانوس اسيلولار بيرتوسيس فاكسين اوكي واضح؟
واضح.
مثلا MMR measles mumps rubella these are live vaccines so usually contraindicated يعني عادة يعني مثلا yellow fever vaccine this is live vaccine should be contraindicated وهكذا hepatitis B لا هذا not contraindicated لازم تعرفون ال vaccinations اكو live attenuated واكو شنو killed recombinant okay that was easy or not
صعبة دكتور
هو طبعا HIV is a medicine يعني شفت المحاضرة HIV is a medicine بس ان شاء الله ترجعون تقروها نشوف الاكو اسئلة على المحاضرة if you can write in the chat in the google classroom ان شاء الله اذا عندكم اسئلة واستفسارات طبعا هو HIV medicine is very difficult medicine لكن احنا نحاول بس principles ركز عليه So the X-ray is typically a reticulonodular infiltrate bilaterally. Patient is hypoxic. And this is typical appearance of pneumocystis jirovici pneumonia. واحنا ايش قلنا عليه هذا المريض معناه شنو اذا واحد عنده HIV infection وهاي الاكس-راي مالته سوينا له مثلا برونكو ليفر لافاج وراء pneumocystis jirovici. شو نسمي هذا المريض؟ AIDS. This is an AIDS defining illness. This is an AIDS defining illness. Okay, واضح حسن؟ هذا شنو؟ This is an X-ray shows a large hilum in a patient with cough, fever, and hemoptysis. This is typical for pulmonary tuberculosis in patient with HIV infection. Keep in your mind that pulmonary TB in a patient with HIV infection it will be atypical. يعني عادة مرات من الكافيتري ليجن the typical one in immune competent patient. رح يجي مجرد انه هو enlargement of the hilum على lymphadenopathy plus lung infiltrate it will be in the lower zone rather than the cavitation cavitation occur in immune competent patient but in immune compromised patient especially in AIDS patient it will be atypical so pulmonary tuberculosis very common infections that may be fatal in a patient with HIV infection so these are the oral candidiasis and angular chiliitis due to candida. These are become persistent in stage 3 HIV infection. Persistent and more severe and refractory to treatment. هذا شنو? This is an endoscopy revealed the esophagus with white creamy patches. Typical of esophageal candidiasis. لذلك إذا واحد عنده HIV patient عنده esophageal candidiasis شنو معناها? The patient, has got AIDS. This is an AIDS-defining illness. لكن هنا هذا مو AIDS-defining illness. Oral candidiasis. بينما الاسفاجير candidiasis is an AIDS-defining illness among HIV patients. CMV retinitis هذا age defining illness or not؟ تشوفون هذا white exudate plus hemorrhages this is abnormal in the case infection of the retina. So I have told you that cytomegalovirus infections outside the lymphoid organs, for example spleen or lymph node, we should regard this as an AIDS defining illness, CMV retinitis. Another example is CMV colitis. Now, تشوفون this is a
toxoplasmosis.
Yes, very good. Toxoplasmosis, and this is a hyperintense area surrounded by edema. Part edema. This is a cerebral toxoplasmosis. Other differential for this appearance, it may be tuberculoma in the central nervous system or lymphoma, primary central nervous system lymphoma. So these are the differentials for this is an age-defining illness. Cerebral toxoplasmosis. هذا هنا شنو؟ شوفوه باللاترال اسبكت مو بالسنترال. هذا هنا شنو هنا؟ كانديدايسس بس هنا شنو هذا شوفوه باللاترال اسبكت؟ This is oral hairy leukoplakia. Oral hairy leukoplakia. And it is virtually pathognomonic of HIV infection. عادة نكون شنو بالبريفرال of the tank, not in the central. So this is virtually pathognomonic of HIV infection. وعادة مو مثل candidate. Candidate can be whipped up by the tongue depressor. This is usually persistent and painless. بينما عادة patient can usually complain of sore tongue and sore mouth. Other diseases in HIV patient, this is you know, oral, this is a Kaposi sarcoma in the nose and disseminated Kaposi sarcoma in the skin. This is also pathognomonic of HIV patient. So Kaposi sarcoma, it may involve the skin, may involve the mucous membranes, and may involve the lung also. So it is a type of cancer caused by herpes virus. Favored site were nose, palate, genitals, and lower limbs. Diagnosis by histopathology. Commonly present as a purple, non-tender, non-proteic papules. What about the HIV related cancers? In the Kaposi sarcoma, then Hodgkin lymphoma, invasive cervical cancer, vulval cancer in women, anal cancer, and penile cancer in men. So these are viral related cancers. So it was found that in a patient with HIV are more vulnerable to these carcinomas. What about the chemoprophylaxis? Chemoprophylaxis denotes to prevent infections, prevent infection rather than treat infections. So when we prevent, when we treat these, prevent these infections from occurrence among HIV patients by chemoprophylaxis. If the patient has got CD4 count very low, we have to treat them to prevent infection. For example, pneumocystis jirovecii pneumonia. Yeah, مريض من شفناه جانا مثلا CD4 count 200 is asymptomatic as well. We have to start chemoprophylaxis to prevent the occurrence of pneumocystis jirovecii pneumonia. فنمدي عادة كوتريمكزازول. هذا الكوتريمكزازول مثل بريم تريميثاكسازول will prevent also other infections. For example, toxoplasma. Okay, and isospora. So the idea behind chemoprophylaxis is to prevent infections from occurrence rather than we wait till the infections will established. For example, cryptococcus, if I can't CD4 count from very low, below 50, we have to start fluconazole 200 milligram daily to prevent the infection. وهكذا. أو الحالة الأخرى أنه المريض هو already have recovered from, for example, Amacobacterium avium complex. يعني صار عنده infection treated, we have to give him a prophylaxis with, for example, clarithromycin plus ethambutol till the CD4 count recover and reach above 50. يعني ممكن هو primary prophylaxis, ممكن هو شنو secondary prophylaxis. واضح الفرق بيناتهم؟ primary prophylaxis, patient didn't develop the infection, secondary prophylaxis, if the patient have recovered, for example, from pneumocystis jirovecii, we have to give contramoxazole till the CD4 count recover, for example, above 200. واضحة طلاب بالنسبة للprophylaxis against these infections؟
دكتور؟
Yes.
دكتور أنا ما أفهم أنت ما السكندري والبرايمر بروفلاكسس.
Primary prophylaxis, the patient has not got the infection. ما عنده ولا هاي الانفكشن ولا واحدة بس هو CD4 count مالته low, very low. So we have to start these ممكن نعطي cotrimoxazole, fluconazole, and valganciclovir. We have to treat by HIV antiretroviral therapy. Once the CD4 count reached to near normal or above 200, we may stop these drugs. واضح؟ هو ما عنده infection. هي في جات للفولو اب كلينيك سوت له CD4 count مالته اول مره طلع مالته مثلا 40. اوكي؟ هي سوت له مثلا اكس راي يعني مثلا جست اكس راي سي تي سكان برين اكزامينيشن everything is normal. But he has CD4 count very low. We have to start primary prophylaxis, okay? With, for example, contramoxazole, valganciclovir, ومثلا clarithromycin and ethambutol. And we give antiretroviral therapy. When the CD4 count improve, you may stop these drugs. You know, CD4 count صار عالي, but the propensity for a pulmonary infection will be very low. هذا بالنسبة للprimary chemo prophylaxis. The patient has not got none of these infections. Secondary prophylaxis, لا. مريض هو عنده هذا الديزيز صار عنده نيموسيس جرافيتي نيمونيا, we treat him. But the CD4 count is still low because the ART need time to recover the CD4 count. هاي الفترة احنا حنبقي على الكوترامكزازول. طبعا دي صار يعني الفرق بين البرايمري والسكندري اضافة للدوز, يعني احنا 690 ملي جرام هذا الدوز مال بروفلاكسز rather than the therapeutic dose. نعطي therapeutic dose patient recover وراها نحول على البروفلاكتيك تل وي مونيتور ذا سي دي 4 كاونت تل وي ابروش ذا نورمال وي ستوب ذس بروفلاكسس. واضح هسه بالنسبه للبرايمري فيرسس سكندري بروفلاكسس. برايمري هاز نوت جت نيموسيس جيروفيتش نيمونيا, بينما السكندري هو عنده المرض وصار منه واخذ تريتمنت وراها نحول الى بروفلاكتيك تريتمنت تل ذا سي دي 4 كاونت ريكفر.
تمام دكتور واضح.
اوكي. And thanks for your attendance. شنو رايكم؟
دكتور؟
يس اذا عندكم اسئله؟ نعم.
بس فكره